Secret Sessions have come here to Vyner Street for an exclusive behind-the-scenes look at the 51st cover shoot for Notion magazine, featuring Patrick Wolf.
So what can people expect from issue 51?
Issue 51 is going to have a menswear focus, which we're leading with the Patrick Wolf cover styled in James Long. Notion is all about the kind of, you know, forward-thinking music and forward-thinking fashion. By putting a high premium on the photography we produce, like today, and the styling we do with it, and combining those two, music and fashion, in great images. It's a, you know, this page is going to be ripped out of the magazine and stuck on the wall.
Yeah.
I think that's what a great magazine does. It has things you just want to take out of it.
Yeah.
And I encourage people to do that.
Fantastic. You're encouraging people to rip apart your magazine, rip it apart,
stick it places, throw it
absolutely.
Places, paper airplanes, throw them into Parliament, I don't mind.
Why did you go for Patrick Wolf?
Patrick is the most natural choice I think we can have. He is, for me, he has been for almost a decade, one of the most exciting pop talents in England. The great thing about Patrick, again, is that it's not just the music, it's the concept that goes with it, it's everything. When you get an artist who pays attention not just to their songs, their lyrics, but also their look, their photography, their videos. When that whole package comes together and works as a unit, as Patrick's always has, you know you've got somebody really special.
So, firstly, congratulations, because you're about to release your fifth album. That must be a pretty amazing feeling, because there's not many artists that make it to three albums and you're on your fifth.
Yeah, it's very exciting. But I guess my ambition is to be like 90 and look back at a life of albums and see my life through records. So yeah, I feel like I'm in the infancy of a long journey in a way.
If you'd say your life is documented through albums, where would you say you are with Luke Kalia?
Well, this album is written around the age of 26, 27. So at that age, I think you're finding your place or your roots more in the world. Mm. I think the last 10 years has seen a lot of running away from home, from normality, and being at odds with the world. And I think rather than sink into a negative frame of mind, to look at the world with a more optimistic attitude, I think. And so yeah, it's been a whole new subject matter for me.
So obviously you play a lot of instruments, and is there anything on this new album that you picked up, any new instruments that people can expect to hear?
Well, on this album, it's a lot more orchestral, for one, so I went into studios and worked with big orchestral arrangements, and then I really wanted to experiment with some more Arabic or Eastern sounds or instruments, and there's an instrument called the duduk, which features quite heavily throughout the album. It's from Armenia. Wonderful sound. It's so small, but it has a huge sound. It's definitely, for me, a breath of fresh air, the production, in terms of experimenting with a lot of new instruments. Really, the core orchestral element and folk element, I think, is still there in the instrumentation. So, yeah.
And you're about to embark on a UK tour. How are you going to bring that to life? The orchestra. I mean, you must have a pretty great live band.
Yeah, my band are wonderful in terms of trying to recreate that the energy of the records. I guess I kind of bankrupt myself every now and again trying to recreate the record, but it's important that whenever there's a bigger show, I could get their bigger string section or woodwind.
And you're excited about playing your new tracks to people?
I've got a lot more songs to learn. I'm trying to learn a lot of my back catalogue as well, and driving my band crazy, I think, learning 60 songs or so. But yeah, I'm very excited. I kind of like to stay on the road for a good few years, so
yeah.